So our group has been interested for many years in understanding how the innate immune system contributes to the pathogenesis of lupus. And in particular, we are interested in understanding how myeloid cells, macrophages, neutrophils, etc., may play a prominent role. And there's a molecule that is present in myeloid cells called CD11b. And genetic polymorphisms in a molecule called EATGAM, which encodes for CD11b, are associated with a very significant and specific risk for the development of systemic lupus erythematosus. What is interesting is, in general, CD11b has both anti-inflammatory and pro-inflammatory functions, but in the case of lupus, it is actually a decreasing function of this molecule CD11b that is associated with the risk for the disease. And so Dr. Gupta has made very significant contributions by discovering and synthesizing a small molecule called LA1 that actually binds to CD11b and increases the function of this molecule.
So we started this collaboration with Mariana a few years back when I met her when she was still at University of Michigan. She has been a pioneer in this field. And we had just recently at that time discovered some new molecules that had some anti-inflammatory properties. So we wanted to explore that with her. And that really started this collaboration, which has been now multi-year, many years in the making. So one of the first findings from this study really was a much more mechanistic correlation between mutations in ITGAM and a biomarker in lupus patients, which is interferon 1. We had been interested in finding out, first of all, do mutations in ITGAM in patients who have lupus, do those mutations increase the risk for lupus because they somehow increase this pro-inflammatory biomarker in these patients? And if there were a correlation, that would point to a new mechanism, that a new pathway, molecular pathway, that one could target. So the first thing we did was we looked at interferon 1 levels in the CDOF patients. This is about 170 patients in a lupus cohort, and looked at whether those patients had a mutation in ITGAM gene or not. And to our surprise, people who had ITGAM mutations had a much more significantly increased levels of interferon 1 in their sera. And that suggested to us that their immune system is somehow overactive. The second thing that we worked on subsequent to this discovery was, since now we realize ITGAM mutations lead to overactivity of immune cells, and we had recently discovered a new compound that could reduce inflammation, we wanted to now test, can that compound be effective in reducing pro-inflammatory signaling by this mutation, by this gene, and then perhaps also figure out mechanistically how that would do it.
So there were several discoveries, and this was collaboration across many different institutions, and many different approaches were followed. But I would say the three perhaps most important discoveries were, number one, that individuals with lupus that carry the polymorphisms in ITGAM that lead to decreased function of CD11b have actually increased levels of type 1 interferons. And type 1 interferons are known to be very important cytokines in the pathogenesis of lupus. The second discovery was that the way by which decreased function of CD11b would lead to enhanced levels of type 1 interferons was through the effects that CD11b have in the TLR receptor 7, FOXO3, IRF3, IRF7 pathway. And so that through genome-wide mRNA screening, we found that in the presence of this compound LA1, this led to the engagement of CD11b, enhanced activity of this molecule, and the suppression of this TLR7-mediated pathway, and therefore decreased production of type 1 interferons. And the third finding was that in animal models of lupus, administration of this small molecule LA1 that enhances the function of CD11b led to very significant decrease in renal disease, skin disease, autoantibody production, interferon synthesis, and vascular damage that is a prominent feature of patients with lupus. Despite the fact that there have been very significant advances in the diagnosis and treatment of lupus, we still lack a personalized approach in which we can find patients that have specific abnormalities in their immune system based in part on genetic polymorphisms that predispose to these abnormalities in the immune system. And therefore, by identifying these abnormalities, we can target them with a specific drug that will either mitigate the abnormality or suppress it. And so the fact that we have found that there is a small molecule that can assess a specific abnormality that patients with the ITGAN mutation that are at high risk for lupus or that develop lupus have, I think we can start to think of strategies to personalize the treatment of these patients in a more systematic way. And of course, there's a lot of work to be done regarding this, but this gives us some initial evidence that this is a possibility.